In this motivational success story, you'll understand that everything is possible. You'll understand how Robert Downey Jr. rose from the bottom and became a superhero. Remember that just because you hit bottom doesn't mean you have to stay there. As a child, he grew up surrounded with drugs. The only reason for that was his father. His father was a drug addict who allowed him to use at the age of 6. His father now regrets this decision. For Robert Downey Jr., that drug use was in a way an emotional bond between him and his father. When my dad and I would do drugs together, it was like him trying to express his love for me in the only way he knew how, and that's how his troubles began. Robert Downey Jr. started acting at the age of 5, and during his childhood, he had minor roles in his father's movies. In 1987 came the role that started his career. He played the role of a drug addict in the movie Less Than Zero. His realistic performance got him many positive reviews and offers from top directors. For him, the doors in Hollywood were wide open for the next 4 years. From 1996 to 2001, Downey was arrested many times on charges related to drugs. He went through a few drug treatment programs, but unsuccessfully. He explained the relapses to a judge. "It's like I have a shotgun in my mouth, and I've got my finger on the trigger, and I like the taste of the gunmetal." In 1996, Downey was arrested for possession of drugs and an unloaded handgun while he was speeding down Sunset Boulevard. In 1997, he was sentenced to 6 months in prison after violating his parole by missing drug tests. During this time in jail, he was attacked by fellow inmates and woke up in a pool of his own blood. In 1999, after he missed another drug test, he was arrested again and spent 1 year in prison. In prison, he worked in the kitchen, washing dishes for 8 cents an hour, and slept on a 3-inch mattress. He ended up questioning his sanity. After Robert Downey Jr. was released from prison, it appeared that he left the drugs behind him and started a new chapter. He was cast on the hit series Ally McBeal, where he was highly praised for his work. But that new chapter was all a lie. He was still doing drugs. In 2001, he was found in an alley behind a motel, barefoot and in a fetal position. He was arrested and fired from the series. He almost went bankrupt. How his life changed. In 2003, he met the love of his life, his current wife, Susan Levin. She insisted that she would only marry him if he gave up drugs for good. So after so many years of struggles with arrests, substance abuse, unsuccessful rehabs, he was ready to work really hard to make a full recovery and never use drugs again. In a dramatic way, he threw all his drugs into the Pacific Ocean. After that, he entered a 12-step program and started doing meditation, yoga, and martial arts. And the biggest battle of his life began. He describes beating his addictions as coming out of a 20-year coma. Getting clean has done wonders for his movie career. In 2008, Downey started playing the iconic role of Iron Man. After almost 10 years in the role, he appeared in Iron Man 2, Iron Man 3, The Avengers, Avengers Infinity War, and many more in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Also, we can't wait to see him in one of the most anticipated movies of 2019, Avengers Endgame. There is no doubt that Robert Downey Jr. has been through very hard times in his life, but he didn't let anything stop him. As one of the most talented actors of all time, one of the most popular actors in the world, and one of the highest paid actors in Hollywood, his net worth is $300 million. So what can we learn from this motivational success story? It's okay to ask for help. You don't have to do everything alone. There is no shame in asking for help. It's never too late to change yourself. Self-discipline is the key. You're creating discipline with your daily habits. And once something becomes a habit, you don't need strong willpower to force yourself to do it. But we know that habits are really hard to change. Your daily habits now are maybe far from what you want them to be. That is because your daily habits now are stronger than your willpower and strength to change them. That's why you should take small steps every day. They require a little action and almost no willpower to do them. And without a doubt, they can be done by anyone. Even if you're a person who goes through life completely controlled by your subconscious mind at this moment, they will take you closer and closer to your goal. One of the many ways to win the war with your bad habits is to use the law of motion. Every time you feel tempted to go back to your old habit, quickly take one small step in a different direction. And remember, you are the master of your own destiny, the creator of your life and your future. If you want your destiny to look like you've always dreamed of, do something about it now. So, what's your story?